Hello and welcome to another Luxul how-to video. Today we're going to be talking about Epic Mesh and setting up a guest network on that Epic Mesh system. Before we get into the hows, let's talk about the whys a little bit. Okay, so what is a guest network? Why might you want one? When talking about a guest network, you're usually talking about a extra network with the purpose of giving some user on the network access to the internet, but nothing else, nothing on the main network. So for example, you wouldn't want somebody on your guest network to be able to log into any of the network equipment and make any changes or anything like that. You'd want that sort of separation there. Most of the time, this is going to be done virtually, either within the router or the access point or that system that you're using there. There's a few different ways that you can accomplish this. One of the ones you might be familiar with is through the use of VLANs, or the virtual local area network. This uses sort of a tagging principle to separate network traffic into separate virtual networks. This is a method that we use on like our controller system and some of our other equipment. If you're looking for a guide on guest networking with VLANs or want more information about just VLANs in general, we have plenty of other videos and other webinars that have talked about that topic, so I won't really go into it anymore here. In our mesh product, you don't have to set up any sort of VLAN rules or anything like that to set up a guest network. It's actually really, really easy. So with that, we'll go ahead and jump into how we set this up. So first step is to open up a web browser. I'm using Google Chrome, but you can use whatever you're more comfortable with. You're going to put in the IP address of your mesh router. By default, it is 192.168.0.1. If you've changed it to something else during the initial setup, make sure that you use that instead. Put in your username and password. So admin is the username and whatever password that you set up in the setup process. Maybe you've seen the web UI of the mesh units. Maybe you haven't, but it's not too dissimilar to what you would normally see. You have your sidebar here, some kind of quick setup page or first page information there. For setting up a guest network, you're going to very simply go and find the guest network tab on that sidebar. And now all you need to do is set up whatever SSID name you want to use. So I might call this Ryan's guest network, whatever you want to name it. The security should be set WPA2 AES encryption, sort of the standard, what you might use there. Set up your password, so I'll put my secret password in there that I want my guests to use. And very simply, enable SSID. That's all it takes to set up the Wi-Fi portion of that guest network. Now, if you want to be specific about the subnet that's being used, you can change that here. If I want this to be something like 192.168, maybe 10.1 instead of 100.1. Maybe I want to change this to be something like a 10.0.0.1, something like that to start with. And you can set your DHCP range starting at, in this case, 10.0.0.50, going up to 10.0.0.200. You can switch that around however you like and increase or decrease the least time, just like you would on any normal DHCP server. Once you have the settings that you want, go ahead and click Apply. This will just take a minute to go ahead and make those configuration changes. And once that's done, you should be able to go on any Wi-Fi capable device, go and find this network and connect with this password just like you would any other network, and keep those devices separated from your main network. That's all there is to setting up the guest network on the Epic Mesh. Hopefully that was helpful just to walk through the process and kind of see the exact screens that you're going to need and the different settings that you're going to need to set. Thank you for watching and have a great rest of your day.